Welcome back. There's nothing like a Christmas surprise when you get a present you really, really, really wanted but didn't dare dream that you might be lucky enough to receive it. That's what has just happened for parents Brian and Judy.
It wasn't something their daughter could wrap. It wasn't something she could buy. It was, however, the best present this mum and dad have ever received.
Chloe Hogan's about to turn 30. It's a big milestone and a natural time to look back.
The morning of her 22nd birthday.
A personal trainer, she was just 2 weeks away from doing the Rotorua Marathon.
5:30 in the morning I woke up and I thought, I knew she'd decided she'd go to work.
I was just going to take the 6 a.m. run. I don't really remember anything else.
Just after 7 we get a knock on the door and it's two policemen. And they told me straight that Chloe had been in a very serious car accident. I said, how bad was it? And they said, really bad. We class it as a level 9, the level 10s. She would be deceased.
Special crash investigation said something came. I swerved for some reason, but they don't really know why.
Chloe was in a coma with a traumatic brain injury similar to a shaken baby.
Yeah, just feeling really numb.
4 agonising days later, they were told she'd live.
So we sort of held on to that, gave us hope.
I don't remember anything and I'm glad.
The family was told she'd never fully recover and never walk again.
But I like to prove people wrong.
Rehabilitation specialist Jane's been working with Chloe all year.
Look where you would like to go, because if you'd like to go to the floor, keep looking at your toes.
Keep looking at the ground.
Okay, otherwise, just nice and easy.
It took her maybe 4 months to remember my name. She was extremely unsteady on the walker. She was just locked in her body. But she had a most amazing spirit. There was no question that she was a person that was going to defy odds.
So when you're ready, just turn yourself around, little baby steps.
Chloe's been trying hard to keep this year's progress a secret. And today she took her first unassisted steps for mum and dad.
Finally, I'll have a hug from you.
Little by little, she's clawed back to where she is today.
How proud are you of her, Ryan?
Immensely. Because she takes great pride in achieving stuff when people tell us she can't.
They have had to go through all of it. They were told that they'd have to turn my life support off. And that would have been pretty hard.
I don't suffer fools. And you know, people that say to Chloe, you'll never walk again, or you know, you've got unrealistic expectations, we cut them pretty well. I'm not having that.
Brian says he suspected she was close, but walking for Christmas?
Oh, huge, huge. That's the mountaintop that we've been looking for. Yeah, to walk into that doctor who said you'd never walk again on high heel shoes.
And my Jimmy Choos.
Yeah.
My new ones. That you'll pay for.
Yeah. She's very quick to tell people she's not disabled, she's injured. She's not sick, she's injured. And both her and I have never given up a full recovery and we never will.
Oh, that is fantastic. What a lovely, lovely story.
Oh, Brian, every time he speaks, it just gets you.
Yeah, that
really
is,
does.
That is wonderful. I tell you, doing the show, you see some wonderful people. That is amazing.
And if anyone deserves those Jimmy Choos,
that's right.
Absolutely.